catching up again this morning with European Metals Holdings, Keith Coughlan. Keith, good morning. Welcome back.
Morning, Andrew. Thank you.
Look, recent development here. You've begun trading on the NASDAQ International. Now, this is it's a fairly new market, this, is it?
Fairly new. It's not the full NASDAQ listing. That is another level of commitment and cost and what have you that is still open to us and we may avail ourselves of in the future. But we previously were quoted on the pink sheets in the US and over-the-counter pink sheets market. And whilst we did trade on that market, it's not particularly liquid. Quite often see significant gaps in the market between bid and offers. And the NASDAQ listing or the NASDAQ International listing now opens up the possibility of buying shares in European metals to a much greater investment audience in the US.
And you've seen some good early volumes here, haven't you?
We have, and it's a growing global awareness, if you like, of the sector. You know, it all went fairly quiet for a year or so there, but with certain macro events that we've seen this year, with COVID refocusing people's attention on securing local supply chains, particularly for raw materials, with the current global situation with China, and perhaps a reluctance to rely on that country for long-term supply chains, with all of the PR being directed at battery industry, electric vehicle industry, and raw materials in Europe, in the EU, particularly important to us specifically, and more recently to Tesla and Battery Day, and the moves that they've made at and since Battery Day, particularly with regard to seeking to secure local supply chains of lithium in the US. We've just seen a significant increase in the awareness globally for this sector. And by this sector, I mean the battery market, the electric vehicle future, and the trickle-down effect to us in the lithium market.
Are you still, just while we're talking listings here, are you still pushing ahead with the Prague listing?
We are. The Prague Stock Exchange is a much smaller stock exchange. They don't have any companies like us listed there. And so this is just causing them some administrative issues getting us listed there. But it is definitely something we are going to do. We are progressing it as we speak. It's just been a little slower than we would have hoped.
But it seems US investors are taking a keen interest in the Cinovec project.
Well, they are. There has been some PR, some independent research put out in the US suggesting that Cinovec would be a very good option for certain, large EV makers, battery makers, to secure supply in Europe. So this whole push towards local supply chains is very beneficial for us. You know, Europe is going to need a significant amount of lithium going forward. We see all of the plans for battery factories for EVs being built in the EU, and there is no production of battery-grade lithium in the EU whatsoever. So really all of the lithium projects currently under development in the EU would need to come online on time to full capacity to get anywhere near satisfying the amount of demand that we're seeing coming out of the EU in future years. And because of the size of Cinovec, the profile, where we are on the development curve, you know, being arguably closer to development and production of battery grade lithium chemicals than others in the EU, we are certainly getting a fair bit of focus because of that. And the focus is from the EU itself in terms of the level of support we're seeing. The focus is also from potential off-takers. You know, our level of discussion with potential off-takers has increased quite significantly in the last 3 or 4 months as we get closer to production and as we get more certain about de-risking Cinovec and getting to production. And obviously, you know, more focus from investors now because of that.
Just adding to what you were saying a moment ago around the EU interest, I think it might have been either earlier this month, a week or two back, we had the news that Tesla says it's building the world's biggest battery manufacturing facility in Germany. I think this is just a couple of hundred Ks along the road from you, isn't it? No doubt they'll be
interested. I think it's 250 kilometres from the Cinovec project. And you know, this is important. We heard Elon Musk talking about the journey that nickel takes to get from the mine, wherever that might be globally, to into one of his cars. He was talking about California. And, you know, that adds significant cost to production, but it also adds significantly to the carbon footprint of that end product. And the world is becoming very, very focused on lessening the carbon footprint. So, you know, there is a new set of rules just come out in the EU about green batteries and ensuring that the batteries that go into these vehicles have the lowest possible carbon footprint, the lowest possible ECG impact. And so if you're putting lithium hydroxide, for example, on a truck at Cinovec and sending it up the road 250 kilometres to the Tesla Gigafactory, clearly that has a far better or far lower impact on the environment than mining something in Australia, shipping it to China, taking it on and off the ship in China, shipping it somewhere else, and eventually getting it halfway around the world. You know, it just makes sense that it is cheaper and better for the environment to do it that way. And that doesn't even address the issues of geopolitical risk.
You say it makes sense. Have you been up there and had a chat with them?
With whom?
Tesla.
Well, we are chatting with a number of potential off-takers, Andrew, throughout the EU. And, you know, the names, you know, we can't talk about, obviously, but, you know, it's fairly obvious who we would be talking to. And this is a key, now that the project itself is going along very well and the consultants and our own engineering team are fully across that and moving it ahead, from my point of view, the most important thing I can do now is to secure offtake for the project early in the new year.
So as far as what's happening on site, Keith, are you still drilling?
We are still drilling and we'll have an update, I hope. Well, I'm pretty sure we'll have an update to that drilling before Christmas. We don't have any barriers to moving around the site. There's no COVID restrictions for us up there. So it's business as usual at site. The drilling has been continuing and we'll report, I think, the first six holes before Christmas.
So COVID to one side, are you pleased with what's been achieved this year?
I am. This year's been a very important year for us. And really, you know, the way the year started from a macro point of view was very concerning. And to have achieved what we have against that backdrop, I think, is significant. Well, effectively, what we've done this year, in a nutshell, is to significantly de-risk the project, to significantly increase the likelihood that this project will go into production, and that it will therefore be delivering battery grade lithium hydroxide into the European battery industry, the European EV industry, as early as possible. And that de-risking has been through bringing CES into the project in February, March, thereby funding the project all the way through to final investment decision. Then further de-risking with the collaborative agreement with the European Union in July, I think it was, appointing SMS as the engineers, the lead engineers to the project shortly thereafter, because SMS, as I've said, will deliver us not only a bankable feasibility study, but they'll deliver us a lump sum, fixed price, turnkey EPC contract that will come with process guarantees, product specification guarantees, and I believe will also bring with it very strong introductions to some of the soft debt that is available in the region for these sorts of projects. So Cinovec is far more advanced than it was 12 months ago.
I know there's going to be a little bit of overlap as far as this next question, but you said a bit earlier, hitting that offtake program hard in the new year is going to be one of your big jobs. What else is on the list for next year? What are you looking to achieve in 2021?
Well, 2021 is obviously when we will deliver the bankable study. And there are a few gateways along the way, ticks in the box, if you like, with regards to things like lock cycle test work, pilot plant test work. So, you know, we have produced battery grade lithium hydroxide and for that matter, battery grade lithium carbonate previously, a product that met everyone's published specifications. But those samples were very small scale. So as part of what we're doing in 2021, we will be producing significantly more product that will then specifically go to the end users that are further up the list of discussions. They will test that product and, you know, that will lead to the finalization of those offtake agreements, which is very important. You know, with something like lithium, you need bankable offtake to ultimately get your finance to build the project. Everyone in the cycle now knows that. And so what we see is the support of the end users for projects at our stage of development, because they know that giving that support enables the project to get into development. And that we saw that absolutely clearly with the Tesla offtake deal with Piedmont a few months ago. Tesla coming into Piedmont, Tesla writing an offtake agreement with Piedmont enabled Piedmont to raise a lot of money to advance their project significantly and thereby make it more certain that they can deliver that product to Tesla when the time comes. And Tesla and others are acutely aware that this is how they need to get developing projects into production to ensure that we do have the supply to meet the very large increase in demand that we are seeing.
Do you feel as though, as you near the business end of things, here, Keith, you're generating a bit of a buzz in the investor community as far as what we can expect?
I think that's a fair call, Andrew. I think that this is not, you know, there is another element to this. There's no doubt. There's a little bit of excitement about what is effectively a new industry. A little bit of excitement about a complete change in the way that people move around the globe from internal combustion engines to electric vehicles and where that goes. There's clearly a buzz about a company like Tesla. You know, that company has captured the world's imagination, particularly in the US, absolutely, completely with the way it's approached this issue, the building of EVs, the development of batteries, and really just a completely can-do attitude to embarking on a completely new industry. So, yeah, there is no doubt.
Good to catch up, Keith. Appreciate your time. Thanks very much.
Thanks for your time, Andrew. Have a great Christmas.